Yeah.
Yo, yo, what's the deal, y'all? It's the Kid Berg, a.k.a. the dude that does this, and you're now rocking with the AM Daily Sneaker Review Show. First and foremost, I want to thank you guys so much for the love and support of this show. It's been a little bit, man. It's been hectic for me, so apologize for the delays in between. I didn't even put up any reels, so I'm going to start putting that up a little bit more. Just wanted to thank you guys for the love and support. If you guys don't mind, please hit the like button. Please turn on your bell for all the notifications, and please subscribe to the channel. Like, comment, subscribe, you know the vibes. New episode back on your head top today. Right now is August 3rd. This video will be up August the 5th, like around 12 o'clock probably, give or take. Oh man, what a great day it is today. First and foremost, before we begin, you see what Nike is doing. If you guys are not aware, Nike is putting out a lot of great sneakers, Jordan brand and Nike. A lot of big releases dropping in 2025. You know, the end of this year, I guess the third, end of the third, going into the fourth quarter, a lot of heat. I have probably three pairs of kicks that I will be buying between now and October. Maybe four or five, actually. So just stay tuned. And then going into October to January, there's a lot of good sneakers coming out. Then from January 2025 to the end of the year, there's so many pairs dropping. So stay tuned. A lot of great sneakers dropping. So check out this show, as I will have all those sneakers available. Trust and believe, I will be getting them. With that being said, new episode back on your head top. I had to get these sneakers. There's a pair of sneakers that just dropped today at 10 a.m. Those who know, know. You know, we're in Olympic times, right? So let's get into it. One of my favorite sneakers ever made right here. Had to get the new version of these for my 2012s are starting to go. These right here are the Olympic Sixes. Oh man, these are fire. Fire, 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 fire. Love these sneakers right here. So happy I was able to get them from the Foot Locker app. Much love to Foot Locker. You know what I'm saying? Very grateful for being able to get these. These sneakers are amazing. I love these sneakers. You know, had to get these. All right, let's get into a review. Let's break these sneakers down. Let's do a comparison. I got my 2012s out as well. I will compare them. So let's get into it right now. All right, before I begin, let's look at the box really fast. As you see, you have this Jordan brand. You have these little patterns here as well on the shoe, on the box, I should say. I apologize. As you see, it says Jordan 4, Jordan 6 retro. I'm about to say Jordan 4. Jordan 6 retro, size 13. I actually got my actual size. As you see inside of the shoe, you have these patterns inside the paper. Patterns inside the paper. I'm just showing you guys. And now we're going to go into the shoe. Sneaker review. We're going to start off with the left side of the shoe. All right, let's go into it. So, again, this is the third time these sneakers retro. Original time was in August 2000 for the Olympics. Second was in 2012. And the third, summer 2012, and then August of this year, August 3rd, 2024. Long overdue retro. Some people wanted the Nike on the back. No need for that. Let's look at the shoe. So, as you see on the side of the shoe, the midsole, you have white with hints of navy blue. Outsole, you have a translucent icy outsole, where you got that navy blue, that translucent, and you have that Jumpman logo in red. Back of the shoe, Air Jordan right there. As you see, you have tumbled leather going all around the shoe. The tumbled leather looked very nice, I must say. Very nice, very nice. You have that Jordan brand on the tongue, and you have the lace lock. Navy blue lace lock. This is not like a, this is like a navy. This red is like a darker red more than a brighter red, I must say. A little bit different. I wish this was a little bit brighter, but it's all good. And the insole, as you see, it says the Jordan, has the Jordan branding where the laces are. So this is your left side of the shoe. Let's go into the right side of the shoe. Then we're going to do a comparison really fast. All right. So again, you have that
midsole with hints of white and navy blue. Translucent icy outsole with navy blue and red. And the Jumpman right there. And this is not a bright red. This is like a darker red. So as you see right here, you have that Air Jordan in the back of the shoe in red. As you see, you have tumble leather going all around the shoe. Literally all around the shoe. Love it. Leather feels really, really good quality, to be honest with you. White and navy blue. Toe box, navy blue toe box. You know what I'm saying? You have that suede Jumpman on the tongue. As you see, you have that lace lock also right here on the actual tongue. It says Air Jordan in navy blue. Of course, the insole has that Jumpman. All right, let me know what you guys think. This is a 2024. I think they did a really good job. I would have actually did a few changes. Right here, obviously, I would have made this a bright red, in my opinion. That would have stuck out a bit more. But let me know what you guys think. I'm going to come right back with the 2020. All right, guys, this is your comparison right here. As you see right here, these are the 2012s. These are a little beat up. I wore these a little bit, you know what I'm saying? These are in good condition. I mean, the outsole obviously took in a toll here. But let's look at some key differences, and I just wanted to just point this out to you guys. So as you see right here, the Jumpman, let's look at the Jumpman right here versus right here. Jumpman's pretty much the same based on my POV. As you see, the lace locks, they got a Jordan brand for 2012, got it all the way right here. They got this bright one for the 2012. This should have been that one. The 2024 should have been brighter than the 2012, in my opinion. Now, let's look at the side of the shoe. Let's look at the... Okay, so let's look real quick. So, this is the... Let's look right here. Obviously, this is the right side of the shoe. Let's do a better comparison this way. So, let's look. So let's look really fast. So as you see the patterns, on the 2024, let's look at the patterns. I see, if you notice, it's pretty much very similar. As you see, let's just look at some differences here. As you see, the icy outsole is a clear difference, obviously, with the outsole. You see, the Jordan symbol, I should say, is a little bit more prevalent on the 2024 than the 2012. Let's look at the back of the shoe. It looks pretty much the same. Let me just look at this. Let me look at that. Pretty much looks the same, in my opinion. Let's look at the 2012. As you see, let me look here. 2012. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much the same. I mean, honestly, I'm just trying to look at some key differences outside of the Jumpman and the insoles. Pretty much the same thing. Let me look here. Yeah, they're pretty much the same thing. I think the key difference is the type of quality when you're looking at the tumbled leather. I think the tumbled leather in the 2024 is a lot better than the tumbled leather in the 2012. 2012 is still good. I just got to clean these sneakers. I wore them last, like a few months ago. They're a little dirty. So I got my Jason Mark sneaker cleaner to clean these up. These are still great sneakers. Glad that I'm able to have them. I'm able to wear them. But, you know, these, I think the 2024 is a little bit better. This is more closer to the OG. If you see some of the key differences right here versus right here on the 2024, this is a little bit more tighter. You know, this reminisces more of the 2000 than the 2012. That's for damn sure. I mean, there's not much key differences, but there's minor differences. In my opinion, two great sneakers. Let me know what you guys think. I think these are great, but I will give the 2024 a little bit of an edge there. So let me know what you guys think. All right. That was your review of the Jordan 6s, the Olympic Jordan 6s, released today, August 3rd for $200, retail for $200. Amazing pair of sneakers. Can't go wrong. I mean, you have to have them if you're into 6s. There's some other color 6s that I don't have in my collection because I just didn't want them or I didn't care for them. But for the most part, the Jordan 6s are one of my favorite Jordans made. The infrared 6s in particular are like top two to me, honestly. But let me know what you guys think. I have a lot of sneakers dropping. I know those DMV foams, those pink ones are dropping on the 17th. I'm planning on getting those. The Amon Amir 3s, I'm planning on getting those.
What else I'm getting? The foam posits, the royal blue foam, September 13th, must have, in my opinion, a pair of sneakers that you should have as a sneakerhead. Let me know what you guys think though, man. Amazing, amazing, amazing. I love those sixes. I also compared them to the 2012. So, like I said, check out this video. Hopefully you guys like it. Like, comment, subscribe. You know the vibes. Share the content. Also follow the official Instagram for this channel, the AM Daily News and Updates Daily. Alright, so final thoughts. Keep God first place. Don't let anybody tell you that you can't, because as long as you wake up in the morning, God shows you that you can and you will achieve greatness. That is my time. I will see you guys next time. Much love. Thank you guys for the love and support. God bless. Blessings.